Hello, this is Mike Willant with Microsoft. Today I want to cover a new technology in Microsoft Power BI. It's called Power Query. And we'll take a quick look at some abilities of Power Query that allow you to look at online data sources and pull data back from those. So we'll be looking at this data from Wikipedia, and hopefully you'll understand a little bit more about Power Query after seeing this video. Thanks. Let's step into Excel now and look at Power Query and Power Map, especially around the European airport. If you come to this Power Query tab and we do, say, an online search, it'll give us this bar over here, and we can type in world's busiest airports in Europe, hit the search button. It's going to then do a query of the web, and it'll give us this slide out of all the different data sets that we can look at. So for instance, I'll just take this 2011 statistics or 2012, doesn't really matter. Let's go ahead and click on that. And what this is going to do is give us statistics of the busiest airports all around the world. Now, I want to filter and shape. I could just start using this data right off the bat, or I could filter and shape it. So let's go ahead and do that. This is going to give us an interface that we can come in and shape our data the way we want to. So while these columns are interesting, they may not be really columns that we care that much about. So let's go ahead and delete these. Now we can remove the columns that we have highlighted, or we can remove everything else, which is nice. We can also do things like remove dupes, remove rows with errors, replace values, change the type, and we're going to do that in a second. We can do group bys, and we can unpivot, which is a really powerful technology that's really challenging to do in traditional SQL, ANSI SQL, or T-SQL, but it's fairly intuitive and simple to do in Power Query. So let's go ahead and remove the columns that we don't want. And then for these two columns, we know that they're going to be numeric. So let's go ahead and change the type to a numeric type, number type. And now we've got the data pretty much in the way that we care about. So let's go ahead and select Done. What this is going to do is take us back into Excel, and we've got a nicely formatted table here. Then what we can do, since we're done with Power Query, let's go into the Insert menu, and we'll go and we'll create a power map of this data. So the nice part about this is that we can take data that's in rows and columns, and suddenly we can get something that's kind of human readable from a mapping standpoint. And that map will then allow us to visualize the data where it resides. So you can see here that the map took us to a place that is over in Europe, spun the globe around automatically, and we'll just hit next since it mapped the city the way we wanted it to. And once that's done, then we can look at our passengers for 2011 and 2012. So very simple to do. We put our passengers on the map, and we can get rid of this if we want, or just move it. Let's just go ahead and get rid of it for now. And what I'll do as well is there's a lot of labels, things you can do, themes, all that kind of thing up here. Let's go ahead and put labels on, and we might also want to zoom in a bit. So now we can get a sense of the world's busiest airports. We can do screen captures, we can create videos, we can play tours if we want, and or we can just flatten it out if we wanted to. So there's lots of options that you get, and we'll go into those in a bit more detail in a second here. But just wanted to kind of show you the power that you have here to quickly visualize geospatial data. And Laura will go into that in more detail. So, thanks.